In the previous video, we learned how to get our FlexView installation ready to create robot behaviors. Now, we are going to get more familiar with the FlexView app, the user interface to design state machines. Okay, this is the interface of the FlexView app you already saw when you opened FlexView to configure it. First, let's take a moment to understand the different elements. In the upper part, you have the menu bar, always available. In the menu, you can always see if FlexView is connected to your ROS application, that is, to a ROS master. When you only open the FlexView app, it will be offline. This means that you can still develop behaviors, but not execute them unless you go online. We will see how to do that when we execute a behavior in the next module. Then, in this part of the menu, you can select your current view, that is, what you see in the entire area below the menu. When we open FlexView, we land in the Behavior Dashboard view, where you can load and configure the properties of your behavior. The other views are the State Machine Editor view, where you define the behavior state machine, the Runtime Control view for executing your behavior, and the Configuration view that you already know. When you select a view, in this area of the menu, you will have the FlexView tools associated with that view. All right, this is basically the FlexView app. In the next module, we will learn how to use the different views to create our own behavior.